Blackstone Audio presents Nomad by Matthew Mather. This book is read by Keith Szarabajka. Survivor Testimony Number GR12. Event plus 49 hours. Name, Dario Holder. Reported location, Central Florida Peninsula.
What do I see? I'm staring out the window of a wrecked home on Sugarloaf Mountain, the highest point in Florida. But Sugarloaf Island would be a better name, and Florida is gone. Just gone. Like we've been transported into some other... I see black water, endless dark skies, no day or night. Gray snow is falling, a dirty blanket of it a foot deep between... Or at least it looks like snow. Only three of us left alive here. Myself and two children. We have nothing to eat. No fresh water. Freezing. Send help. For the love of God, please.
Transmission ended in high ionization static. Frequency 7350 kilohertz, LSB. Subject not reacquired. Day 1, October 16th. Chapter 1. Rome, Italy.
Big enough to what? Destroys the entire solar system, repeated Dr. Mueller, a 60-something pot-bellied man with thick spectacles below a tangle of gray hair. On the Earth's visit.
Ben Rollins stared at him in dumbfounded silence and rubbed his bleary eyes.
That's what I thought you said.
He wiped his hands down his face to pinch the bridge of his nose between his forefingers, squeezing his eyes shut. Opening them, he brought his hands away from his face together, as if in prayer, and exhaled slowly.
Are you serious? Is this a joke?
No joke. We need you, Ben.
Dr. Mueller pointed at a chair. Ben stared around the wood-paneled conference room he'd been unceremoniously dragged into at 3 a.m. Familiar faces, many looking even more haggard than he felt, nodded at him. Ben did a quick inventory. 5 people he recognized as fellow astronomers, all of them exoplanet hunters like himself. He didn't know the other dozen dark-suited shadows hanging near the edges of the room. Ben took a deep breath and focused on Dr. Mueller, his clothes rumpled, 2-day-old stubble on his chin.
The hell was he doing here? And what did he say? We need you?
Ben hadn't seen or even heard from Mueller in 20 years. He slumped into the seat, his mind still off kilter.
In 2015, we discovered that 70,000 years ago, Schultz's star passed through our solar system,
Dr. Mueller said in his thick German accent, continuing his presentation.
We now know that other stars transit our solar neighborhood every few tens of million years, some close enough to disrupt the orbits of the planets.
He paused to take a drink from a glass of water on the podium at the front of the room. His hand trembled.
New data from NASA has uncovered that our solar system has been falling toward a massive object we previously mistook for dark matter in the nearby arm of the Milky Way. However, the anomaly is much closer than that.
What kind of mass? Someone asked.
Perhaps tens of times larger than our sun.
Have you been able to image it?
Dr. Mueller shook his head.
Thus far, we are only detecting it through gravitational effects.
And how far? What path is it on?
Ben asked.
That's why I've asked you here.
Dr. Mueller began pacing again.
I need to get access to your data. Need you to assemble your teams.
But you must have a guess.
Ben held his hands wide, palms up. Dr. Mueller gripped the podium and stared at the plush red carpeting.
Our best guess?
He paused to emphasize the word, looking up to lock eyes with Ben.
Is that Nomad?
Nomad?
That's what we're calling it, whatever it is. It's heading directly toward us at extremely high speed.
He enunciated each word clearly to make sure nothing was misunderstood.
We estimate it is now less than 20 billion kilometers away. At most, we have a year, perhaps only months, until the anomaly reaches us.
Ben stared into Dr. Mueller's eyes. A tingling of dread shivered from his scalp to his fingertips. It expected some answer, perhaps only...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.